So this worksheet covers unit conversion. The first question here asks, the speed limit on some interstate highways is roughly 100 kilometers per hour. It asks us to convert this to a couple different units. So first off, we're asked to convert this to meters per second. So we're looking at 100 kilometers per hour converted to meters per second. So it looks like we're changing both the numerator and the denominator, so we need to think about what factors we need to do that. So I'm going to start a list over here of conversion factors, which are just equalities, right? How many of one unit is equal to another unit? So maybe I'll start with time, right? So if you think about it a little bit, you can convince yourself that 3,600 seconds is 1 hour. All right, so let's do that. Let's do 100 kilometers per hour and multiply by one, right? We're filling in a fraction that is equal to one, but it's a specific one. We're using the conversion factor to fill in this fraction. So we want hours to turn into seconds. So we need hours in the numerator to cancel out with hours in the denominator, and we need seconds to show up in the denominator. All right, now this conversion factor informs how we fill this out. So we have 1 hour and 3,600 seconds. So now we can look, the hour goes away, we're left with seconds, and that's what we want. So now let's turn our attention to the distance. We want to convert from kilometers to meters. So we'll come up with another conversion factor. Maybe we remember that 1 kilometer, and remember that kilo means 10 to the 3. Right, so we can just say 10 to the 3 meters. All right, so it's really easy to confuse where to put the 10 to the 3 when converting in metric prefixes. Maybe it's simple with a kilometer and a meter, but it's more confusing when you think about the less common prefixes. So you should think critically about this. Are there 10 to the 3 meters in a kilometer? Well, yeah. A meter is smaller than a kilometer, so we need a lot of them to make 1 kilometer. So then we can fill that in our conversion factor here. And we have got a kilometer in the numerator, we want that to go away. So we put it in the denominator in our fraction. And then we put meters upstairs. Then we use this conversion factor to fill that out. So it looks like 1 kilometer is 10 to the 3. Meters, we can cancel out some units, kilometers and kilometers. Looks like we're left with meters per second, which is what we want. So if we do that math, our calculator tells us 27.77777, going on forever in meters per second. All right, so typically we would look at this number and say, well, that's only one sig fig. But if you read the instructions, we're going to allow for 2. So that rounds up to 28 meters per second. Excellent. Okay. So letter B here says, well, let's turn this 100 kilometers per hour to miles per hour. Right? Miles per hour. Sometimes we write that MPH. Okay, so we'll set this up, 100 kilometers per hour, and it looks like the time is already okay. We're just going from kilometers to miles, and you may actually remember this conversion directly. 1 mile is 1.609 kilometers. All right, that's not the only way to do this, but if you remember this, looks like we can do this in one step. right? So we'll fill in our fraction. We want kilometers to go away, goes downstairs. We want miles to show up, so we say miles here. And then we say 1 mile is 1.609 kilometers. We'll check the units quickly. Kilometers and kilometers cancel. We've got miles per hour. Looks like that's correct. And the number we get for this is 62.1504 miles per hour. And if we round that to two significant figures, that's 62 miles per hour. So now we can look at question two on this sheet. Question two says a certain car is reported to have 1.8 liter engine. What volume is that in cubic centimeters, right? So a liter is a volume, and we're going to cubic centimeters, which is also a volume, right? So we should think cubic centimeters, that's centimeters cubed, right? We're also given this handy fact that 1,000 liters is 1 cubic meter. All right, so that gets us halfway there. This is given here because it's not on the table that I gave you on my courses. So we'll start by saying we want to go from 1.8 liters to cubic centimeters. All right, so 1.8 liters times something. Well, we have this hint here. That's a good place to start. So liters on bottom and cubic meters on top. And it says that there are 1,000 liters per cubic meter. All right, so looking at the units canceling here, puts us into cubic meters. And then we need to go from cubic meters to cubic centimeters. Well, if we recall that 1 centimeter is 10 to the minus 2 meters, this will help us with this conversion, right? Again, we get this because centi is 10 to the minus 2. If you look at the metric prefix list. So we'll fill in that factor here. We want meters to go away. We want centimeters to show up. And it looks like it's a 1 centimeter into 10 to the minus 2 on the meters. But we're not quite done, right? Because there's only 1 meter and 1 centimeter, at least the units here, right? There's 1 centimeter and 10 to the minus 2 meters. But unit-wise, there's just 1 meter and 1 centimeter here, and we need to get rid of 3 meters multiplied by each other. And the way that we do that is we cube this. So we cube this factor, and now it seems pretty clear that cubic meters here will cancel with cubic meters here. And we have to remember to distribute this cube to everything in this parenthesis, right? So that we do end up, meters cubed goes away, we do end up with cubic centimeters, right? Cubic centimeters here, right? So when you do this math, you end up with 1800 cubic centimeters, and that's it.